Weekend Update with Cecily Strong and Colin Jost.
Good evening. I'm Cecily Strong.
I'm Colin Jost, and here are tonight's top stories. L.A. Clippers owner Donald Sterling was banned for life this week by the NBA for making a series of racist remarks, after which I'm guessing he made a few more. V. Stiviano, the ex-girlfriend of Donald Sterling, continued to insist that she did not release the recordings of Sterling's racist comments, though I don't know if I'd trust a woman who sounds like she got her name from how often she's a defendant.
President Obama's approval rating this week fell to an all-time low of 41%, though his jeans are still at an all-time high. This week, the Vatican elevated Pope John XXIII and Pope John Paul II to saints, which will give them the power to appear as statues on your grandmother's lawn.
Toronto Mayor Rob Ford announced this week that he is taking a leave of absence and will suspend his re-election campaign to go to rehab after a new video emerged of him allegedly smoking crack. You know, if this Rob Ford saga has proven anything, it's that crack must be great.
This week, Ukraine launched its first major attack against Russian forces that have occupied the country's east. Here to comment is a woman who lives in a small village in Russia, Olya Pavlotsky.
Hello, Cecil. Thank you for having me.
Oh, Olya. So, are you worried that all this fighting will make it to your village in Russia?
No, I wish it would come. Come and get me, Ukraine. Free me from my earthly prison.
Oh, yeah, come on. Russia can't be that bad.
Oh, really, Cecil? You know, my one-year-old niece just said her first word. You know what it was? You!
That's rough. I'm with you. That's rough. Okay, so what do you think about Putin trying to seize Ukraine in the first place?
Oh, it's dumb. It's like, oh, great job, Putin, make Russia even bigger because Russia's not big enough already.
Okay. Sure.
Putin, I have three words for you. Cut it out.
Wait, all right. Is that from Full House?
Yes, we just get this show in Russia. I love this show. It's about the luckiest family in the world. Only 9 people in one house. If someone was like, hey, come live in this house, there's only 9 of us, I would say, you got it, dude.
Wow. And that's a very current reference, Olya.
Oh, and that Dave Coulier. Oh, what a hunk. Hubba, hubba. If I ever saw him in person, I will give him my sexiest, flirtiest smile.
Oh!
Oh,
no. That's not a smile.
Thank you, Cecil. You know, I like you. You should come to Russia with me and we can go clubbing.
Oh, okay, sure. We can have a girls' night.
Yeah. Ladies, leave your man at home. The club is full of wolves and it's very dangerous.
Oh, wow. Russia does not sound great.
I know, Cecil. That's why I was looking forward to summer vacation.
Oh, okay, that's fine. Where are you going?
I was going to go to East Ukraine, but now it's Russia. So, you know, FMP, am I right, Cecil?
Oh, I think you mean FML.
No, I mean FMP. Feed me, please. I'm stuck. What is FML?
Oh, that's a thing that people in America say. It means like F my life. Like people say it if they oversleep or miss the bus or something.
Miss the bus, huh? That make Americans say F my life? If that is F my life, then F my life times infinity! People say this for real, Cecil?
Yeah.
You're not pulling my leg?
No.
Good, because it will pop right off.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Well, now we've really gotten off track. Okay, now President Obama has threatened further sanctions on Putin, which could affect trade between U.S. and Russia.
Who wants to trade with Russia? Our only exports are homophobia and snow.
But the sanctions could also limit imports, which would affect your life.
Oh, that is tough. That is tough. I am between rock and the hard place, you know?
How so?
Because that's where I live, Cecil. I live between the rock and the hard place. But still better than living next to Kimmy Gibbler, am I right?
Wow. Any new shows in Russia, huh?
Yes, yes, we do. No, I love Game of Thrones.
How do you watch that?
I have an HBO Go password. I'm not animal. Cecil, this season is so good. Oh, but do you know who I hope dies?
Who?
Me.
Olya Pavlovsky, everybody.
It was reported this week that country music legend Willie Nelson earned a fifth degree black belt. Read more about it in this month's issue of That Can't Be Right. A man in China accidentally unearthed a 700-year-old figurine after he pulled over to the side of the road to relieve himself and discovered he was urinating on the object. It's a story the man loves to tell most when people are holding the figurine.
This week, Amal Al-Medin, a brilliant Oxford-educated human rights lawyer and a former UN advisor, settled for a 52-year-old man. You really liked that one, huh?
I really liked that.
The creator of the Cronut has introduced a new dessert called the Waffagato, which is vanilla gelato in the shape of a waffle and covered with maple syrup espresso. Perfect for staying alert while the nurse explains how your insulin pump works.
This week, Nupita Nyong'o was named the most beautiful person in the world by People magazine. Here with her thoughts is our in-house image expert, Leslie Jones.
Thank you very much, Colin. Hello, everybody. I wanted to come out here tonight and congratulate Lupita on winning People's Most Beautiful Person. And I agree that she is very beautiful. But for me, personally, I'm waiting for them to put out the most useful list. You know what I'm saying? Because that's where I'm going to shine.
The most useful?
That's what I said, you delectable Caucasian. Let me ask you a question. If you walked in a club and you saw me and Lupita standing at the bar, who would you pick?
Wow.
Yeah, I know. You would pick Lupita.
Wow.
But let me ask you this. If you was in the parking lot and three Crips is about to whoop your ass, who you gonna pick then?
I would pick you.
You're damn right you would. And that's my point. The way we view black beauty has changed. Look at me. See, I'm single right now. But back in the slave days, I would have never been single. I'm 6 feet tall and I'm strong, Colin. Strong! I mean, look at me. I'm a mandingo.
But Leslie, you're not saying you'd rather be a slave,
no,
right?
No, that is not what I'm saying. I do not want to be a slave. Hell, I don't like working for you white people right now. And y'all pay me. I'm just saying that back in the slave days, my love life would have been way better. Master would have hooked me up with the best brother on the plantation. And every 9 months, I'd be in the corner having a super baby. Every 9 months. Every 9 months, I'd just be in the corner just popping them out. Just Shaq. Kobe. LeBron. Kimbo Slice.
Sinbad.
That's what I'm saying. I'm saying I would be the number one slave draft pick. All of the plantations would want me. I'd be on television like LeBron announcing which plantation I was gonna go to. I would be like, I'd like to take my talents to South Carolina. I do believe that there's gonna be a lot of opportunities there for me. Now, I can't even get a brother to take me out for a cheap dinner. I mean, damn, can a bitch get a beef bowl?